Welcome to another session of Wireless Communication Networks, Unit 1, Wireless Communications, Communication System Fundamentals and Modern Wireless Communication Systems. Today we discuss about the examples of mobile radio systems. Here the term shows mobile, what is meant by mobile? And the term shows radio, what is meant by radio? Right. Here the term, first of all, we discussed about radio. Here, what is meant by radio? Radio is nothing but instead of using wireless, we are using radio. Nothing but air is the medium between transmitter to receiver or source to destination or sender to receiver. Air is the medium. At that time, the system is called the radio system. Here, what are the examples? Nothing but where exactly used this air is the medium. Here, suppose a number of different applications are available for this mobile radio communication systems. Suppose the best example is garage door openers. Suppose we are taking remote control. We have to, based upon remote control, we have to open the doors of the garage. And you in your home, you are having entertainments, either TV. Suppose we have to control the TV by the remote. Suppose we have to control AC by remote. Here, whatever it be equipment, we have to control it remote. That is the transmitter is receiver, the receiver is TV or the receiver is AC, whatever it may be, we have to control through air is the medium. On cordless telephone. Here the cordless telephone is nothing but it is just like the public switch telephone network, that is landline telephone network, but the receiver, that is handset, in your landline telephone handset and telephone dial pad having a wireless connectivity, not a wired connect. That is a cordless telephone. And you know walkie-talkie. Here we have to set a frequency between two walkie-talkies and connect between two telephones. That is handheld walkie-talkies. And pagers. Pagers are nothing but which is a device which is used to receive only messages. Only messages. The other name for these pagers are beepers. And the present we are using cellular telephones. Cellular telephones are also examples of the mobile radio system. Here, the services for this, all the examples, it depends upon the cost of the equipment and performance and the type of service which we are used. And complexity. Suppose now we are using 4G network. Here for this purpose, based upon the GB which we are used per day, that based upon that only we have to pay the money for that one. That is the services offered by the service provider. Right. Here, based upon these small examples, we are going for taking some few examples. We are going for explaining the some of the examples. Here in this first one, we are going for the term is mobile. Here, what is meant by mobile? That here nothing but suppose we are go for landline telephone. The landline telephone, it is a fixed one, fixed in your home in some place. But we are taking your mobile phone, nothing but is the handheld. That is, we have to take within the hand and move from one place to another place. That's why it is the mobile one, from one place to another place. That's why it is called as a mobile. That is, mobile is nothing but it is a radio terminal. It is moved during operation. And this mobile phone is a portable device. Nothing, what is meant portable? It depends on portable, nothing but size is very less. It is a handheld. Handheld. Next, that term is subscriber. Who is subscriber? Who can use the particular network? Who can pay for the services of the service provider is called a subscriber. What is subscriber unit? Subscriber is about mobile phone. Subscriber is customer. Subscriber is mobile phone. Then both this combination is called a mobile unit. Here, in general, the mobile phones is not a fixed one. fixed one. It is movable from one place to another place. But that service providing, that is the network, that is mobile tower, mobile cell phone network tower, is a fixed one. It is a fixed one. Only mobile is moved from one place to another place. Here, based upon these terms, first of all, we are going to discuss the basic terms of this mobile radio communication. Here, the first one is base station. Here, what is meant by base station? Here, the base station is a fixed station in a mobile radio system, which communicate with all mobile units within the service area. Service area, you know, the cell phone tower is nothing but base station. Here, the cell phone tower or base station, or base station, it is fixed on one point. Here, this base station has what are the equipment this base station contains? The base station contains power unit, that is power required, right, to working of this base station. Power generators, all cooling purpose, we are using cooling for the units in the base station. At the top of the tower having antennas, transmitter antennas, receiving antennas, some are having both transmitter and receiving antennas. This is about base station. Next, control channel. Here, what is meant by control channel? Suppose you have to dial a number in your mobile phone, then automatically send a signal to nearest base station, that is cell phone tower. Cell phone tower to main control unit. Here, this is a process for set up a call. That is call setup, call request, call initiation, and other control purpose. We are using these control channels. Here, what is meant a control channel? The control channel is nothing but which is used for setup a call. Next, forward channel. Here, the what is meant a forward channel? Here, the forward channel is nothing but once the setup a call. Call is set up now. The information, whether it is voice or data, whatever we have to receive from base station to your mobile, that is cell phone tower to your mobile, is used for forward channel. Similar reverse channel is nothing but from your mobile to base station, that is mobile to cell phone tower, is using for reverse channel. Next, full duplex systems. Here, what is the full duplex systems? It is a two-way communication, that is transmission and reception can be done at a time. The best example of full duplex system is your mobile phone, landline telephone. At a time, we can go for conversation. Next, half duplex system. Here, what is meant by half duplex system? This is also a two-way communication, but not at a time. First, we have to send. After sending completion, then we have to receive. That is our half duplex systems. Here, simplex system is nothing but it is a one-way communication only. There is no reply from the receiver to transmitter. Next, handoff. Here, what is meant handoff? The process of mobile is moving from one base station area to another base station area. Suppose within your city, number of base stations are available. Suppose you are moving from one place to another place, or that automatically the base station network also can be changed. Service at that time we are go for handoff without terminating a call. Nothing but you are taking your mobile and call is under process. You are moving by car or two wheeler, and automatically the cell phone tower can be changed from area to area. At that time, without terminating a call, we are going for handoff process. Next, mobile station. Here, what is meant by mobile station? A mobile station may be handheld, that is portable. Here in this mobile station contains your mobile unit plus SIM card. That is called a mobile station. Next one is mobile switching center, MSC, which is nothing but which coordinates all services. That is which can connect all base stations to one point is called the MSC. The other name of MSC is called the MTSO. That is the main functioning of this cell phone network, it is done by mobile switching center. From this mobile switching center connected to landline telephone network, connected to number of base stations. That is called the mobile switching center. The other name of this mobile switching center is called the MTSO, mobile telephone switching office. Next one is page. Here, page is nothing but a brief message can be broadcast over entire service area. Over entire service area. That is called page. Only messages can be forwarded. Next, roamer. Roamer is nothing but the subscriber or customer can move from one service area to another service area. That is called roamer. Under this, we go for the mobile under roaming. That is, we are moving from Andhra telephone circle to Karnataka telephone circle. We are roamer in Karnataka telephone circle. Next, transceiver, nothing but. It is a single antenna which can both functioning of transmitter and reception purpose. And subscriber is nothing but a user who pays subscription charges for using a mobile communication system. Here, these are some of the basic definitions which we had used to entire 5 units. Here, the mobile transmission system. Here, the transmission system is nothing but sending and receiving. Here, in this mobile data transmission system, can be classified as 3. That is simplex, half duplex, full duplex. Here, the simplex is nothing but which can transmit only one direction. That is the best example of this one is the pagers or paging system. Suppose if you go for your mobile, we are receiving some messages from the network, so your network service. That is, they are commonly sent same message to all subscribers. Is it possible to give any requirement? It is not possible. That is only service message we have received. That is about simplex systems. Next, half duplex system. Half duplex system is nothing but which allows the subscribers in a two-way communication, but not use the same radio channel for both transmission and reception. That is, once that transmission, the transmission is completed, then only we have to give acknowledgement, not at a time. Suppose you are going for your WhatsApp. Here in your WhatsApp, you're having a mic option is there. Instead of typing message, you're going for press the mic and talk, then send that voice message to receiver. Is there anything you have to reply? Then the receiver transmits acknowledgement. That is, push to talk, release to listen. That is, we have to talk, we have to push the mic. That's why it is push to talk and release to listen. Next one is full duplex system. Here, the full duplex system is nothing but is also two-way communication, which provides simultaneously both transmission and reception. Right, here, based upon these three transmission systems, we go for examples. The first example of this mobile radio system is paging system. Here, what is meant a paging system? Paging system is nothing but which can send a brief messages to subscribers. Brief message. The message contains a numeric message. We have to type numeric message or alphanumeric. It contains both numbers and letters or voice message, whatever it may be. Short message can be sent to subscribers. Here, for these paging systems, subscriber having a particular need is different pagers for this. Here, the pagers are which are used for news headlines, stock quotations, and faxes also sent. Here, how it works. The telephone having telephone which are having connected to modem. Suppose the modern landline connections. The modern landline connections are having, suppose I go for in 5 years back, Tata Indicom, Reliance, the landline telephones are having a top, having one screen is there, which is used to receive the brief messages. Here, generally, the paging system which are used in the urban areas, within the coverage limited of 2 kilometers, 5 kilometers. Why? Because we need a separate pagers are required for this paging system. We are using only 2 kilometers to 5 kilometers stage for this to receive the page. And it is very simple. It is simple and inexpensive. Here the pagers are also used already PST networks. We are connected to PST networks also for this one. No need for separate network. Here simultaneously the service provider sent messages. Okay, nowadays we are using mobile phones. The mobile phones also used as a pagers for receiving messages. Suppose we are going for some apps are there. Suppose some news apps are there. They are sent a short, simple news item. Simultaneously, they are broadcasting where the apps are installed in the mobile units. Here, the paging systems are designed for reliable communication to subscriber where they are in building, where in driving on highway, where in flying in airport, whatever, wherever it may, we have to receive the right. Here, what is the power required? For transmission side, we required a large power, transmitters required, but to send these messages, right? Here, see this one, the figure. Exactly was the, what is the paging system, right? Here, see this one. This is a paging main control center is there. This paging center connected to PST, landline telephone. From this paging control system, here number of cities are controlled by one paging control center. These are landline link only connected. Here each and every city having one tower. This is tower is called the paging terminal, which can transmit brief messages to pagers. This is about city one. This is about city two connection. Likewise, city n. Here, see this one. Some cities are controlled by landline wired link only, but from this paging terminal to pagers is a wireless. You see this one. Here, this person having pager from this. Paging terminal, we are receive the message, but not reply. Only one simplex, only one way communication. In sometimes for distance between this paging control and paging terminal is increases. At that time, instead of using landline, we are using satellite links also. Here, this paging control center dispatches pages received from the PSTN throughout several cities at the same time. See this one in this figure also, they are giving arrow marks in the only one way communication. Next, we are going for cordless telephone system. You know the meaning of this cordless telephone system. Actually, the cordless telephone system also working with full duplex communication system, which is used a radio to connect portable handset to dedicated base station, which is connected to a PSTN. Suppose you in your home having a landline telephone. Here, see at the top of the top view of this landline telephone, which is having a dial pad. I think a dial pad. Not only dial pad, above the dial pad, you are having a handset. From handset to your landline telephone, one wired connection is there. That is two to four pair wire is there. Suppose we have to remove the wire and connect a radios between handset to your telephone. Then we can take the handset and move inside your home, inside your city. Then it is called a cordless telephone. This cordless telephone also connected to general PSTN network. Here, actually, the first generation of this cordless telephone, which we are used only few tens of meters. But nowadays, in second generation cordless telephones, which we are used few hundreds of meters also. Few hundreds of meters also. Actually, this cordless telephones are used in the first in outdoor locations, urban centers such as London. They are tested in London and or Hong Kong, right? Here, this is exactly what a cordless telephone system. This is about PSTN network, that is public switch telephone network, that is landline connect networking, total networking. From this landline network connected to fixed port base station. That is, but in your home having this fixed port, that is landline telephone. From landline telephone handset. Here the landline telephone to handset is wireless link. Here in this cordless telephone having dial pad. This is a radio which you are used for transmit and receive the signal to from the fixed port. This is about cordless telephone. Next, we are going for the next example of this mobile radio system is cellular telephone systems. Here, cellular telephone systems. First, we are discuss about what is meant by cellular. What is meant by cellular? Why it is called cellular? You know the mobile telephone. What is meant by mobile telephone? The telephone moving from one location to another location with a handheld portable device. It is moving. That's why it is a mobile telephone. The same same thing having cellular telephone. Why it is called a cellular? Suppose you are taking a city of Tirupati. Is it possible for one base station to cover the entire city of Tirupati? It is not possible. Why? The number of subscribers are high. Suppose each and every base station or cell phone tower having a number of base station. Each and every base station having some fixed channels. Suppose I am fixing each base station having 100 channels, nothing but only 100 subscribers are used that cell phone tower. What about remaining? Number of subscribers are high. At the same time, we are going for increase the number of cell phone towers or base stations for fully covering city. At that time, we have to divide the total city area into number of small areas. Each small area called the cell. It's called as a cell. That's why it is a cellular telephone network. Then only it is covers the total system. Instead of large geographical area, the large geographical area can be divided into small parts. Each part is called as a cell. Each cell is having one cell phone tower for better quality service. That's why it is called a cellular telephone. Suppose the mobile is moving from one cell phone tower, another cell phone tower. It is called a handoff. Without terminating a call, without disturbing a call, it is moved from one cell phone to another cell phone. Next, here, now I am going for the main block diagram of the cellular telephone network. See this one. Actually, this is the large geographical area. This can be divided into small parts. Each part is called as a cell. Each part is a cell. Each and every cell having one cell phone tower. See this one. This cell phone tower, if you have to fix it at the center or edge, it can be depends upon the type of geographical area. Suppose in geographical area contains hills, valley points, forest area. Based upon this, before going to installation of that tower, in that particular cell, we are going for check where exactly you have to fix that cell phone tower. It covers or not total cell phone. Cell coverage area. Here, all these cell phone towers or base stations are connected to one point is called the MSC, Mobile Switching Center. The other name for Mobile Switching Center is called the MTSO, Mobile Telephone Switching Office. Here, the MSC or MTSO intent connected to PSTN network, that is landline telephone. Here, the what is meant of wireless here? Only wireless is from the cell phone tower to your mobile unit. These are wireless. Here, in general, cellular mobile communication, instead of mobile figure, we are used car symbol. Car symbol is used. Car symbol is used for Car symbol is used for mobile. That is movable from one area to another area. Yes, see this in this figure. Suppose this is a cell phone tower. We have to fix one frequency, F1. The adjacent tower having frequency F2. That's an F3, F4. Likewise, we have to use different frequencies for different cell phone towers. Different cell phone towers. Why? Because we are getting some instead of different, we are using same frequency, nothing but it is difficult to maintain the network. It is difficult to maintain interference problems. We'll discuss later classes what is meant by interference. That's why we are using different frequencies for different cell phone towers working. Right, here see this one. Suppose here in this base station, we are having frequency F1. This is F2. Again, this one we are in frequency F1. Why? Because this is not adjacent. Some distance is there. That is the concept of frequency reuse. We discussed coming classes. What is meant by frequency reuse? How it can be used in cellular networks? Here from this figure, right? We are going how the call can be made. Call can be made. Suppose, right? How you can identify your friend's number based on a telephone number? The telephone number is called as a mobile identification number. That is MIN. MIN is nothing but mobile identification number, subscriber telephone number. Telephone number. How a cellular telephone call is made? Call is made, right? Suppose that roll number one in your class can be made, call made to roll number 15. Nothing but first the roll number take her mobile and switch on the mobile unit. Once I switch off the mobile unit, the particular cell phone search the signal and take a signal from nearest base station, the nearest cell phone tower. Nothing but one setup channel or control channel is allocated to particular mobile unit. Nothing but once you have received the signal in your mobile unit, this is vertical bars. Nothing but one setup channel or control channel are allocated to particular mobile unit. Nothing but it can use for voice transmission or data transmission. Once you have to receive the signal, then go for dial a number. Once the dial a number, it sends the particular number to nearest base station, that is cell phone tower, from cell phone tower or base station to MSC or MTSO. Here in MTMSC or MTSO is the main heart of the cellular telephone network. Nothing but which contains databases of all subscribers, which is used for set up a call, all functioning and maintenance and services are done by MSC or MTSO only. Once the telephone number is received by MSC, the MSC searches where exactly the receiver is present, which cell phone tower receiver is present by using searching. Once the searching is completed, then call should be connected between transmitter to receiver. Once the call is connected, then we are using two voice channels. One is forward voice channel, another one is reverse voice channel. Here, what is the use of two voice channels? For these two voice channels, we are using for full duplex systems at a time. Forward voice channels, which is used for you have to receive your voice from cell phone tower to your mobile, from reverse from mobile to cell phone tower. Once all that done completed, at the same time, when the call is under progress, at the same time, MSC or MTSO, it can be records calls automatically. Record the calls and how much time they are used how much suppose we are going for data searching, how much data they are used. Once this call is disconnected, then automatically we are giving you some message like how much data you can used and how much time you are utilized the network. This is about how a cellular telephone call should be made. Here the mainly that here we are checking is MIN, that is mobile identification, nothing but subscriber number. Next, here electronic serial number, ESN, electronic serial number, nothing but this is the number which is having your SIM card. Once we are checked above the SIM card, you are having electronic serial number. It should be match the phone number and electronic serial number. This is about how the call should be taken in cellular and mobile communication. And the topic of handoff, handoff is nothing but the mobile is moving from one cell phone tower to other cell phone tower without breaking your call. We are using your handoff. And roaming nothing but the subscriber which can used different service provider areas, nothing but suppose we are registered under AP telecom circuits, but suppose we are moving to Karnataka telephone circuit, we are under roaming in the Karnataka telephone circuit, nothing but we are getting roaming problem, we are getting roaming charges also. This is about how the cellular network works. Now we are going for comparisons of mobile radio systems. Here see this one, comparison of mobile systems based upon mobile. Suppose this is about this contains service, coverage range, required infrastructure and network complexity, hardware cost, carrier frequency, and what is the functionality. Suppose we are taking TV. So here see this one, the table is comparison of mobile communication system with the case of mobile station. Suppose TV remote control, nothing but your remote. You're taking remote, which is usually the coverage range is low within the room. Infrastructure low, complexity low, hardware cost also low. Within the 80 rupees, 70 rupees, we are getting this remote control. And what is the carrier frequencies? Infrared signals we are used. What is the functionality? Transmitter. Your remote is transmitter. Next, garage door open also. Like coverage area low, required infrastructure is low, complexity is low, hardware cost also low. The carrier frequency which you use for transmission is less than 100 megahertz. The functionality is also transmitter. Next, paging system. Here in this paging system, nothing but your pagers, paging unit. The coverage range is high in terms of kilometers. That's why infrastructure also we record high. Why? Because we are using a tower. And complexity is low. Hardware cost is low. The carrier frequency in terms of gigahertz, and it is actually the receiver only. We have to receive the messages, brief messages. Next, cordless telephone. Coverage range is low in terms of meters. Required infrastructure also low, but complexity is moderate. Hardware cost is low. The carrier frequency is less than 100 megahertz. The cordless telephone works as both transceiver and receiver, which transmits your voice and receive the voice. And cellular phone, nothing but your mobile phone. Coverage range is high. Wherever you can go, the network comes. And required infrastructure high, and complexity is high. Hardware cost is moderate. Some mobiles, smart mobile phones also, we are coming under 7,000, 6,000 now. And carrier frequency in terms of less than 1 gigahertz, it acts as both transceiver, nothing but transmitter and receiver. This is the table is comparison of mobile communication system in the case of mobile station. Next, this is the table contains comparison of mobile communication systems with respect to base station. Here, first one, TV remote control. In this TV remote control, what is the base station? TV. What is the coverage range? Low. Required infrastructure low. Complexity is low. hardware cost is low, carrier frequency is infrared, and TV is able to receive the signal from the remote. That's why it is a functionality is a receiver. Next, garage door opener. This is just like a TV remote control, except the carrier frequency. The carrier frequency for garage door opener is less than 100 megahertz. And paging system, in this paging system having base station, that is tower is there to send brief messages to number of pagers. And coverage, whatever coverage, required infrastructure, complexity, hardware, all are high. The carrier frequency also in terms of gigahertz, which functionality is transmitter. Next, cordless phone. Coverage is low, infrastructure is low, complexity is low, hardware cost is moderate, and carrier frequency is less than 100 megahertz. Functionality is, it has both transmitter and receiver. And final one is cellular phone. In that cellular phone, cell phone tower, we have to assume now. Coverage high, required infrastructure high, complexity is high, hardware cost is high, the carrier frequency is less than 1 gigahertz, which can have which are having antennas which works both transmitter and receivers. These are the comparisons of mobile communication systems with respect to mobile station and base station. Right. This is about the examples of mobile radio systems. Here in this mobile radio systems, today we discuss about, right, what are the basic definitions of cellular and mobile communication. And examples of mobile radio systems, that is paging systems, cordless telephone, cellular network, and comparison of all these examples. Right, this is about the examples of mobile radio systems. Do you have any query? Type your query in a chat box. Thank you very much for attending today's class.